It's Simlsy here, so welcome to another speed build. So today I am back building again for my save file, and this time I am building a townhouse for the Pleasant Sisters. They are a household that's been in The Sims a long time. I never heard about them until Discovery University, so forgive me. I mean, I've heard about them because I think I've had requests in the comments to build things for them even before they were in the game, but I knew nothing about them. So that's why I never did it before. But now that we have them with Discovery University, I definitely wanted to give them a new townhouse because the pre-built one, I did not like it. I didn't like it at all. And so it took me a little bit of time to figure out exactly how I wanted this townhouse to look. There is another one that is identical to the one they had before that's like right across this like pond here in the center. And so I'm trying to decide if I should make the townhouses look different from one another or mirror this townhouse shape for the other household that lives there. I think it's like an elderly couple. Do they have a child or a grandchild that lives with them? I'm not exactly sure, but let me know what you guys think. Should I do a completely different style of townhouse, or should I mirror this townhouse but on the other lot? I don't know. I'm not exactly sure which way I want to go with it, so definitely let me know your guys' opinions. But yeah, the Pleasant Sisters, so they are twins, and they're both young adults, and they're university students. There is Angela, who is, she's a lot more feminine and soft. She's a bit more girly. It says that she wants to be a painter extraordinaire. She is neat, good, a foodie, and she's a muser because she wants to be a painter extraordinaire. And she has a few different skills. She has cooking level 4, painting level 5, and writing level 2. And the only relationship I guess she has is with her sister, according to the Sims community website. That's probably accurate because I feel like every Sim has like no friends. And so it's kind of funny. But yeah, her sister is like the exact opposite of her. So her sister is called Lilith, and she's a bit more grungier. She's a bit more like, she has a bit of a darker style to her. And she is also a young adult. Like I said, she wants to be a public enemy. So that gives her the dastardly trait. And it says she has the tough walk style, whereas her sister has the feminine walk style. And so I feel like, I'm not sure what that walk style looks like anymore. Is it like where they kind of sway their shoulders a little bit more? I'm gonna have to check that out because I can't remember. But anyways, she has a sweet voice, it says, just like her sister, and she is a loner, a kleptomaniac, so that means she likes to steal things. She is a slob, and she has cooking level 3, mischief level 4, and painting level 5. So they're both pretty artistic. Even though Lilith doesn't want to be an artist, she is still pretty artistic herself. So I think I ended up giving her a piano. And then I was thinking that she would probably have the drawing tablet like in her inventory, and maybe she just doodles like every once in a while, but she's not like super serious about it. She just likes to do it for a bit of fun every once in a while. So maybe we can go along with that storyline for my save file. I'm not exactly sure. And yeah, her relationship is her sister, Angela. Now I know there's like this whole lineage, I think, with their family. I'm not exactly sure all of the details. I'm sure a lot of you guys know, so you can definitely let me know in the comments. But yeah, I really like these sisters. It was a lot of fun building a house for them. It took me a while with the floor plan because I really wanted this house to be 3 stories with a basement. And that was basically because like looking at the surrounding buildings and like this whole style that, I was gonna say Brindleton Bay, but it's Brightchester. This world of Brightchester, if you look around the neighborhood, you can see the different townhouses have that like basement area. And so I knew I wanted to have that. I ended up turning it into like a game room because I was thinking it'd be kind of fun if Lilith ends up throwing a lot of parties and it just drives her sister crazy because her sister is trying to be like really studious. Oh, I didn't mention which schools they were a part of. So Lilith is a part of Foxbury, and then Angela, was that her name? Hopefully I remember correctly. Yes, it is. Okay, Angela is a University of Brightchester student. So I end up giving them each a banner in their room just to sort of represent the different schools. I didn't like go totally like decked out in school spirit. I just wanted to reflect it a little bit with a banner. I mean, the banner's kind of over the top. I don't know if I would have had a banner of my university that I went to in my bedroom, but you know, I thought it was pretty cool for The Sims anyways. But as you can see, I'm just working out the floor plan and trying to figure out the stairs. I really wanted to stack them on top of each other for this build just to save space, and plus I had like the perfect wall to put them on. And yeah, I think it actually worked out really nicely in this build, so I was really happy about it. I was trying to delete that part of the floor. I gave up pretty early. I probably could have made it work. I don't know, it looks a little bit strange having that floor stick out underneath the stairs. Hopefully it doesn't bother you guys too much, but yeah, it was kind of bothering me a little bit. But you will notice that I have to move the stairs around a ton because they won't stack on top of each other. They like try to drop to the floor. Oh, you know what? If I would have turned the grid on, it probably would have worked. Looking back, that's probably my issue. That's so frustrating because I moved the stairs so much trying to get it to work, but that was probably my issue. Definitely. But anyways, the way I end up decorating it, Angela has the second floor and then Lilith has the very top floor. And I decided to continue with their style in their bedroom. So Angela has a pinker bedroom. It's a little bit more girly and soft. She also has, they each have their own office space, and then hers has an art easel in there. There's also a computer desk so she can sit and do her homework or browse the internet or whatever she would like to do, and then she can also do some painting. And then Lilith's bedroom is a lot darker. It's a bit more, I don't want to say gothic. I don't think it is necessarily. I don't know, that's not a style I'm too familiar with, so I'm kind of hesitant to use that term, but definitely has darker colors. And they each have their own bathroom, like an ensuite bathroom. And then yeah, like I said, they both have an office too. So Lilith has an office and she has a computer desk as well. I didn't give her an art easel, but she has, I think, a bookcase in there. I don't know. I think hers ended up being a little bit smaller. We'll see it later on. But yeah, I was really happy to be able to give them both so much space. But I mean, since I was only building this like basically four-story home for two Sims, they were bound to have pretty big bedrooms. And I was trying to think of how they came across living in this really nice townhouse. I mean, I think it's really nice. Some of you guys may disagree, but I think it's probably pretty fancy for a couple of college students to live in. I think I've heard before that they have like a wealthy family history. And so I was thinking it would be kind of neat if this was like an aunt's townhouse and she passed away and left it to the girls. Like she knew that they were going to be going to school here, or maybe they, you know, maybe they moved into it and then decided to go to school here. I don't know exactly how I want it to go. So let me know if you guys have any ideas, but I thought it'd be kind of nice if it was like an aunt's house. Because what I ended up doing, as you'll see here on the interior, I'm using a lot of black. I used a lot of black on the exterior because it made it feel like kind of updated to me, and so I really liked that feel. But once I started decorating the house, I was using a lot of black, and then I felt like it was just Lilith's house and not Angela's house too. And so even though the exterior is kind of updated with some black, I mean, I don't know if you guys agree that the black makes it look updated, but that's how I was feeling. But bringing that much black onto the interior just didn't make it feel like it was both of their houses. And so going with that whole aunt idea, I felt like it just made more sense. So I decorated a lot more traditional and used a lot more browns and stuff too. So yeah, I liked that a lot better because I just really wasn't liking it before, and I decided to cut all of that out. So hopefully you guys don't mind, because yeah, this video is already like 30 minutes. So if you would see me mess around with a whole other interior style, we'd probably be here for another 10 minutes. And yeah, that's just too much. Actually, I do have a 40 minute video, or like 38 minute video, coming up pretty soon. And I am so, so excited about that build. It took me forever. I spent all day yesterday building it, and it's based off of a movie, and I have never built anything. At least I don't think I have. Yeah, I don't think I've ever built anything that's specifically like copied from a movie. Tell me if I'm wrong. I think I'm remembering correctly that I never have done that, because it was pretty tricky. So I was like watching the movie. I don't want to say it because I don't want to give it away, because it's kind of a Christmas surprise, maybe. Maybe it's a surprise. I don't know. But I was watching the movie as I was building. But building and watching a movie is kind of difficult because you end up having a lot of pauses, and then the movie was over like way before I was done building. So I had to go back through and like look at little clips of the movie and then look at like pictures on the internet, trying to find the different angles of the rooms. And it was so difficult. It was a totally different experience, but I think it actually turned out really nice. So yeah, I think I'm going to try to share that on Christmas Eve. Maybe Christmas Day. Yeah, I think actually I'm going to share it Christmas Day. Looking at my schedule, I think that's going to be how it goes. So yeah, hopefully you guys do enjoy that. I am going away for a couple of days for Christmas to go see my parents and some family, but I am pre-recording. Don't worry, there's not going to be like a huge gap in videos again. Like I've mentioned so many times recently, I just had a lot of stuff going on the beginning of the month, and then I also needed a break, so I'm sure you guys are sick of hearing about it, but yeah, I feel like I should probably mention it. But anyways, so yeah, I have that pre-recorded. I do need to do the voiceover, so I will do that later today. And then I also built something else in Sulani, and I'm really excited about it. I think it's super cute. I don't know what it is, but recently I've had like the urge to build there, and I've been looking at tons of inspiration on Pinterest. If you guys do happen to follow me over there, I know some of you guys do. You probably have noticed that I was gonna say reblogged, but no, that's not the correct term. I've pinned a lot of like tropical paintings and like different like sort of tropical artwork that are like paintings of houses and different landscapes in tropical areas. And it's just like super inspiring. It's my favorite way to get inspired to build in Sulani. And recently I've just been totally obsessed, which is kind of weird because I feel like I should be more into building like cabins and like wintry homes, which I am. I definitely have done a couple. I did that collab with Miss Griffey. And if you guys haven't seen that, you should definitely check it out. That was such a fun collab. And then also that Christmas video, like I was talking about. So yeah, there's a couple of wintry things. I guess I also built that orange house in the winter, but it wasn't Christmassy. I don't know, but I just feel like building tropical things at the moment. It's kind of weird. But anyways, I've been rambling through the landscaping. I wanted the landscaping to be pretty lush. I used a lot of the live edit objects for the plants, mostly because I wanted to keep the cost down. I'm not sure if it really matters because this house is probably super expensive whether I use regular plants or not. But you know what? The live edit objects just have a ton more options, so I prefer it anyways. And also those window boxes with the red flowers are so, so pretty, and I just can't help but use them. You will see here in the backyard though, it's a bit small. I don't know, these lots are really tiny, and I feel like for it to look like it belongs here in this world, like the house needs to be pretty big. And even this one, like looking like at the house from a distance, it looks pretty small. I actually built some starter houses over on, well, I'm gonna say starter, but it's like 40,000. So as I've mentioned before, I am building starter houses for my save file so your Sims can just move in there right away and you don't have to cheat, you don't have to move anybody out and all that kind of stuff. And I wanted there to be a starter house in this neighborhood. And the other lot where the original starter house is, I really wanted like a row of townhouses. So technically there are two houses there, and so it's like 44,000 simoleons. So I'm hoping that you would probably live there with more than just one Sim and then probably have some roommates who live next door or something. I don't know. Hopefully you guys don't mind that it's so expensive and I'm probably still going to call it a starter house. But if I were to make it cheap, it would not look correct. Like I wouldn't have been able to do the three stories. I don't even think I included a basement in those because I was trying to save money. But a basement is definitely something that I think would make it look a lot better. I'm excited to share it with you guys because I think now I'm completely caught up on starter houses. I know I've said this before, but every time we get a new world, I have a new starter house to build, and it's something I like to do in my spare time. And yeah, I should have a video ready pretty soon, hopefully. But like I said, I am going away for Christmas just for a few days. And then I do want to share an early release of my save file. So I'm trying to get organized with that and making sure all of the houses are where I want them to be. I have basically everything that I have finished so far in my save and just kind of checking the details because I'm really particular about my save file, as you guys probably know by now. And if I'm going to release an early version that's not complete, like I want it to be as best of an early version as I can, I feel like I'm so disappointed that it's taking this long, but it's like such a huge project, so I know I shouldn't beat myself up over it. And obviously we're always getting new worlds, and we get like several packs a year that have new worlds, and so it's just like the lots are never ending. It's pretty ridiculous, but I do have a lot of them done, and I really do like what I have done so far. And of course I will continue to build for it and then update it. I'm not sure at what point I will update it again, like another 20 lots. I don't know how many it should be. So if you guys have any opinions, of course, as always, let me know in the comments so I can try to figure out what I'm doing. But here you can see I am decorating the interior. Like I said, I went with a more traditional kind of interior. I wanted it to look kind of dated, so this was like their aunt's furniture that they left behind. And I really like it. I really like this kitchen. It's such a unique shape. It's kind of like a, I don't know if you'd call this a galley kitchen necessarily. I'm not sure. I feel like I should probably know by now what a galley kitchen is, but I don't. And you know, I'm not an architect, so it's just how it goes. But I really do like it. I like how there's that little bar in the corner with the bar stools. I think that's super cute. And the sink is like detached from the counters. I felt like that just made it feel a little bit older. Like, I don't know if you guys get what I mean, but it makes the build feel older that the sink is separate from the counters. They don't have like a modern sink in the countertops. I feel like, I don't know, I feel that way. Hopefully that makes sense to you guys. And I think it looks really nice. And I think the kitchen's just nice and cozy. Also the living room too, I think it's super cozy. It took me a little while to figure out the couches. I really wanted to use the couch that came with this expansion pack. I think it's a really nice couch. It just comes in a lot of colors that I think are difficult to use, especially when you're going for a more neutral color scheme. And so I ended up not using it. And plus it doesn't have any pillows. And I just really wish it did. It would make that couch so much better. Actually, I saw recently, way after I built this, I saw this like just a couple of days ago. I don't know who it was by, so I do apologize. But somebody shared on Twitter that they sized down like that really simple base game chair, and then they merged it into a couch and like overlapped it to look like pillows. I think that's so smart. I'm definitely gonna have to try out that idea. If I remember, I will try to link that tweet in the description so you guys can see what I'm talking about, because it's kind of hard to explain. But it's really cool. I think it's really smart, and yeah, definitely check that out. I'll try to remember. If I don't, please let me know that I didn't link it in the description so you guys can see it if you're interested. But over here is going to be the dining room. I think the dining room is probably my favorite room. It's very simple, but I love this round dining table, and then with the black chairs, I just thought it looked so nice, because I did want to have a few like black pieces just to tie in the exterior a little bit. And plus like the front door and back door are black, and I don't know, I feel like, maybe this is just me, I feel like it makes a house feel more cohesive if the interior matches the exterior. Like, not completely, but like since there's so much black on the interior, I wanted to use some furniture pieces that are black, and like I did the stove and the refrigerator, and it just made it feel so much more cohesive rather than doing all creams and browns. So yeah, I don't know, I think it looks nice, but I just really like this dining room. It's very simple, but I think it's just really cute. And then here I am messing with the chairs again. I think I do end up leaving. Oh no, I use these ones instead. I like those chairs too. I think they're both nice. And then moving on to the second floor. So like I said, this is going to be the floor where Angela lives, and she has her own ensuite bathroom. You'll see here as I'm decorating it, I'm using a lot of black accents, but I feel like even if her aunt had black curtains in here, she would probably switch them out for ones that she prefers. So yeah, I make them pink, I think, or like a cream color later on. And then I also have her robe in here. It's a black color. I change that later too. But yeah, the bathroom's nice and simple. There's a shower and a bathtub, and yeah, it's nothing too exciting. I think I used basically the same objects that I used in the downstairs bathroom, but it's just a bigger version of it. I think this build ends up having four bathrooms total, which is pretty crazy since I only imagined, well, I mean, I only built it for two Sims, but you could definitely have more Sims in here if you would like to, because each of their offices could easily be another bedroom. And you could probably make their bedrooms even a little bit smaller, because I just made them big because I had the space to do it. And then there's the basement area. And so since I had that whole area, I decided to put another bathroom down there. And you could even expand further and add more bedrooms down there. So you could have like 8 Sims living here, no problem, I'm sure. But yeah, you can see I am decorating Angela's room. I decided to use this bed that came with the expansion pack Discover University. It's not very pink, but I thought it was pink enough that it looked very like soft and feminine, and I thought it suited her pretty nicely. And I used a lot of like white furniture, and then I used this chair. This one did come with Discover University, and finally like one of the colors worked perfectly. Oh, and I don't keep it. Oh, I changed it. I kind of wish I would have left it pink. That's kind of disappointing. Maybe I'll change it back. I don't know. Which one do you guys prefer? I actually really liked the pink when I was looking at it just now. Oh well. But she has a vanity table over there with some makeup and decorations. Here I was trying to figure out if I should put something underneath that artwork. I think later on I realized that I didn't give them any laundry hampers. I forget exactly when that is, but I think that's where I end up putting it. But over here you can see she has an office space and she has this nice bay window. And so I decided to put a few little plants here, and I thought that was pretty nice. And they do have a bit of a weird color to them because they have like outdoor lighting on them, so it's a bit disappointing, but I still really like it. And she has some extra art supplies in here. I've recently been loving merging this like side table with the art supplies into another surface and like sizing it down so it looks like it's sitting on a surface. I think it looks pretty cool. I'm just really eager to have more like crafty decorations. Like, I am so excited for the new stuff pack. It's probably not going to be out till, I don't know, how long do you guys think it's going to take? It's probably going to take like 6 months, maybe, I'm guessing. I'm talking about the community voted stuff pack because the arts and crafts theme won, and they recently shared some concept art, and oh, I'm just so excited. Like, oh, I'm so excited for all the clutter. It's gonna be so much fun. So I think that's just my way of pretending I have a little bit more clutter than I actually do. And then I also gave her a guitar because I thought that would be kind of nice for her to play around with. I don't know, I feel like I give my Sims guitars a lot. I'm not sure why, but I feel like every Sim like plays the guitar. At least I feel like I give them quite often. Maybe it's because my husband plays the guitar, and so we have a lot in our house. We have like 3 or 4 guitars like just sitting around in various places. Maybe that's why I do it. But there you can see I am switching up Angela's bathroom just to suit her personality a little bit more. And then I use the black accents in Lilith's bathroom just to make it look more like her personality. And it ties in with the rest of the house, I think, a little bit more, because I think I use those black curtains a few other times, maybe in the hallways, or I think later on in the hallways I end up doing that. I'm not exactly sure, but oh yeah, I do. You can see it right here. But over here is going to be her bedroom. I gave her these heavy black curtains. I feel like she would be the type of Sim to pull them closed and maybe like to just be in the dark and feel a bit more isolated. And so I thought that was pretty appropriate for her personality. And since she is a klepto, I gave her that sack of money. I think it's a base game item. Maybe it's Get to Work. I'm not exactly sure, but you'll see it here in a moment. It has like, it's like a duffel bag. It has money like spewing out of it. It's a pretty cool item. I wish though that we had a version of that bag that was closed and we could just set that bag places. Do you ever feel that way about a certain piece of clutter? You're like, only if it was just a little bit different, I would use it a lot more, because I feel like for most Sims, they're not gonna have like a bag of money just sitting around. But since she likes to steal, she's probably, you know, I don't know if she's like that good at stealing that she'd be able to steal that much money and get away with it, but maybe she's just into like some very shady businesses and she makes a lot of money doing it. I don't know. Let me know if you guys have any ideas. Like I said, I'm still trying to work out their story for my save file and how I want it to go, but I really enjoyed adding that detail. I thought it was a lot of fun. But yeah, I did give her that keyboard like I mentioned, since she did have some painting skill. I feel like she is a bit artistic and maybe she likes to play the keyboard. And then also, yeah, I was thinking she has a drawing tablet in her inventory. But over here I do end up placing, I think it takes me a while to get to it, but that skeleton that we have, it looks so cool. I end up putting it by the bookcase and I thought it was so Lilith, and I definitely think she would decorate an office space with it. And then she has her computer desk. I gave her a laptop. And this is a skeleton that I'm talking about. I thought that was so cool. And then over here, I think I end up putting her school banner, if I remember correctly. Yeah, I just gave her the Foxberry banner, and then in here I give Angela the Brychester one. It's not that exciting, but I thought it was kind of a nice detail. That way, if you guys forgot which school they go to, you could just easily look at their rooms. Maybe that's not necessary. I don't know. But here you can see I'm decorating the hallway. It's nothing too exciting. I kept it pretty simple. Just a side table with a few decorations, and then there's a clock, and yeah, it looks nice, I think, but it's not very exciting. I was going to put a chess table up here, but it's a bit crowded. I do think I end up placing one on the very back balcony. I think I do. But here I'm moving down into the basement. So like I said, I was thinking that Lilith ends up throwing a lot of parties. I feel like it's kind of contradicting to the way I see her, because I don't think she's a loner, isn't she? Ooh, maybe it kind of doesn't make any sense. Yeah, maybe it doesn't, but maybe she just has like a few close friends. So she's not like throwing parties for people she doesn't know. Maybe it's just like a small group of people that she's in like a club with or something, and they come over and they're pretty loud and they drive Angela crazy. Let me know if you guys like that idea, because yeah, I think I was thinking that she just throws like really raging parties and anybody's free to come. But if she's a loner, that's probably, that doesn't really make any sense. But yeah, I wanted to give them the ping pong table. They have a stereo. They also have a bar down here. And then I place a couple of like posters and I think a couple of like flea market chairs. I tried to make it look more like a college student's house down here. Maybe the aunt didn't really use the basement too much, or maybe she just had a few things in boxes and maybe the girls just sold them once their aunt passed. I don't know exactly how I want to go with it, but I really liked putting those string lights on the ceiling. I thought that was a nice detail. I thought that was really pretty. And then here I'm just placing a bicycle by Angela's bedroom. I think I do put one out in the front of the build that I think I was planning on that one being Lilith's bedroom. So yeah, totally up to you guys how you want to play with that. And then I put a TV down here, and then I'm just adding the final few details, and then we're on to the screenshot. So hopefully you guys have enjoyed this build, and I hope you guys do enjoy the screenshot. So thank you so much for watching, and please leave any comments or suggestions that you have, and I'll talk to you guys soon. Bye.
I want to close my eyes and go back, play it in my mind, a movie of us two. Yeah, we were happy at the time. Can't remember what it felt like. We used to be so strong. That picture perfect sky now, it looks so gray and cold. We've been laying here since 4 a.m. and you haven't said a word to me. Silent treatment, is this what it feels like when your heart is aching, when it bleeds? In July, got stuck out in the rain, but we danced around and didn't mind it. So young and reckless, baby, you and I fit just like a glove, but I guess that's over now. We've been laying here since 4 a.m. and you haven't said a word to me. Just say it out loud. treatment? Is this what it feels like? If it's over.